the sound gets started at all.
Let me see if I can get this thing turned up.
Does it have a volume control? Okay, that was all the way. We had some AV difficulties with the show. I apologize. I usually do that. It might take me down about 2-3 tips, thank you. Usually I try to do a little more organization on like the theater AV. I didn't get a chance to do it, but I have to say that it was very successful. I think we had a tremendous effort, tremendous show. I want to thank everyone for coming. Thank everyone for doing what I asked. Sometimes I was a little rude about it, but I think you all understand we're trying to get a lot done. It's awesome seeing all the faces. A lot of you guys were in my hotel room last night, which is pretty crazy. Wow. So we have a couple things that we're going to do for the end of the show. And we talked about it. We're going to try to make it happen. What we're going to do is we're going to ask Joe Torre to come up. He's going to read a poem as the way only Joe can. And then when that's complete, we're going to bring up all the machines from the history table, and we're going to set them up here, and we're going to take some photos, and we're going to basically honor what we've done here and create that a nice image to remember and to hang. I'm very excited to see that. So we'll have all the classics, Next Generation, up here. Dave had a quick question or statement. What is that, sir?
Thank you. A great mystery. Serial number one has sat in my office for 30 years. And for those 30 years, there was no logo. Brought it here, there was no logo. Saturday morning, there's a ball logo on it. I would love to know how that happened, if anyone knows.
Missing wire, the appearing logo. Wow.
Only the Amiga can make it
happen. That's incredible. So clearly there's a manufacturing issue with the first one that has now been resolved. Yeah. You know, I was looking, setting this machine up at the floppy disks that were in there. And I recognized the discs that I had downloaded from the internet to send to you.
Yeah, they're yours.
It's kind of like the beginning. Does it work? It was a lot of effort, a lot of energy to bring this all together. It was incredible, absolutely tremendous.
Yeah,
when they say, what's that? The only job I've got is to be crazy enough to stand up front. So, without further ado, because it's getting hot in this room, sorry, we're going to ask Joe to come up, read his stuff for us, and then we're going to do a little hustling to get the machines up here for one last photo.
For usage guidelines of how the Boing ball is supposed to be, what it's supposed to look like. Petro had begun doing this years before Gateway bought it when he was a restaurant, so there was a lot of things, a lot of corrections that needed to be made. So I also realize it's a little bit too serious, so I made a poem about it, and I'm going to read that for you. Also maintains these ping pong balls. Here's the poem. It's called Ode to Boing. Published in the Amazing Amiga magazine, thanks to the NCAU user group sending it to them. I just sent it to them. In the beginning, there was the ball, and it was Boing. And the gurus of the day created the checks, and they were marked. And the marks thus made were red amidst the white, even in number yay, and odd like a pattern. And there were square all over the form, and the number of them, being a creation of programmers, was set.
As he gazed upon the ball,
thou shalt see eight across, and eight in all, by its own ball, that many tall.
And if you see only half the ball,
and that number seen is 64, then it is good.
Yea, twice the eight across is 16, the number of bits of a C64. The total of them all is 128, the next one, that was great. But lastly, the ball was tilted, like the earth, so that when it spun, the moving colors changed scan lines, making the trick harder and the demo greater. And that tilt was clockwise in 16 degrees. And the ball went forth, and it is forever Boing.
I just love this demo, I've always loved it, and I realized that taking it too seriously, I was kind of a hard ass when it was my job to be, and I was very picky, you know, all Boing balls, false Boing balls, they were 10 by 8 or 12 by 10, and really annoying because sometimes it'd be like a 3 by 4 Boing ball, but then seeing today the hat, the plush toys, and some other red and white things, if it ever evokes a memory in you, that that's a Boing ball, then it's a Boing whatever it is, it's a Boing hat. It doesn't have to be 8x8 in creation of programming. It's the creation of all the creativity of all the people that love the Amiga, and I hope you will continue remembering it forever.
That's a lot more upbeat than the speech I was going to give about Gateway and how they screwed it up, and Petro and Germany. And
So everyone, let's get up.
Let's head over to the history table.
Just the people on the machines get it?
No, I have like four up there. I can't carry them. Let's just walk over there. Let's just bring the machines back. And we'll set them up.
No screens, no
computers. We have some here, no screens. Just unplug, grab machines, gently. They belong to people who love them. And we'll bring them up.
You contributed to the 1,000 launch on the center. Everyone else? Come on, everyone. Come on, everybody.
Hello.
Arnie, you can get up.
Arnie. Everybody.
Oh, everybody.
Come on.
Okay.
Come on, we're gonna
I love taking a picture of you, so if you're standing behind someone, I don't have extra.
Yeah.